The next thing we want to consider is what's happening to the behavior of our function around values for x where our function is undefined. So for instance, in example 7, we want to consider what's happening as x approaches 0 and as x approaches 2. In both cases, we can see that the function is undefined. So at f of 0, we have a vertical line that our function is going to get closer and closer to without ever crossing. We've got a gap or a break here. And the same thing, if we add a little bit of definition to our graph to say that we have open circles at either end here at this break, we can see that f of 2 is also undefined. So we have two different points where our function is undefined, but the behavior associated with those points where our function is undefined is different. In one case, we've got the open circle, so we've got that gap or break there. But around x equals 0, what we have is a vertical asymptote. So let's take a look at the limits as we approach from both directions to see what some of the differences are, at least in terms of establishing these results, to tell the difference between vertical asymptotes and just holes or breaks in the graph. So if we take the limit of our function as x approaches 0 from the right-hand side, we're tracing along our graph in the as x gets closer and closer to 0 from the right, we're headed to positive infinity. If we take the limit as x approaches 0 from the left, we can see that our function is plummeting down to negative infinity. And we have a vertical asymptote at x equals 0. At f of 2, where our function is also undefined, if we take the limit as x approaches 2 from the right, we're going to get a function value of 10. And if we take the limit as x approaches 2 from the left, we'll get a function value of probably right around 4 or so, wherever exactly that's coming in. And we have no vertical asymptote. So the difference between these results is that we got values of infinity for these limits and real numbers for these values. So in part A, since at least one of those one-sided limits, so just at least one, they don't both have to be infinity, if at least one of them is approaching positive or negative infinity, in part B, we have both of our limits, both of our one-sided limits approaching some number. So if one of our one-sided limits approaches either negative infinity or positive infinity, we know that we have an asymptote occurring. If both one-sided limits approach some number, then there's no vertical asymptote. All we have is just a break in the graph at that point. So that's going to be our method for detecting vertical asymptotes, is looking at what's happening to the behavior of our function, specifically with those limits. So something to keep in mind, if we take the limit of our function as x approaches some number a, and that result ends up either being positive infinity or negative infinity, again, this is a case where technically the limit does not exist based off the definition of a limit for a function, but we would still say that that limit equals infinity or negative infinity to tell us a little bit more information about the behavior of the function around that point.